have already come in useful.
Yeah.
Now you hear the grinding? That's Bart. He started on a tiny home. Gooseneck trailer, and he's gonna build it from the bottom up.
You see there's a crack right up along there. And this is where the there wasn't enough gap in there to get a decent penetration weld in there. MIG just doesn't dig that hard, so all I'm going to do is I could weld it with stick or I could back gouge it. I'm just going to back gouge it because I got the MIG welder up here. And you know when DeWalt gave me these grinders, they gave me these really thin discs, and I didn't think much of them. I mean, the thing's only 40 thousandths wide. So I thought, oh, that's not going to last. And you know what? They're holding up really good. And so if you just need a thin cut through something or a cutoff, they work great. And Bart's been using them down there on his trailer, and he likes them too.
Yeah. Straight edge.
Yeah, everything brightens up.
Yeah.
Doug really wants you to clean the nozzle when it looks like that.
All done, tying in the frames, and some of you have asked about the holes in them. They're not really for anything other than good looks, tying down cargo, and maybe the occasional woman, but or guy, or how you, live life, have fun. And what we did is we didn't do a solid weld along here because we didn't want to distort the outside of the boat and give it a skinny cow. Where needed and we had a big gap, you just put in a piece of rod or you actually filled that thing. But the idea is to get it structurally in, and it's not a kind of weld that you have to keep water out. The idea is tied in real good, and it helps support this chine. And the other thing it helps to do is support the keel because it ties into this piece of steel, which goes on down into the keel. That way, because the boat, hits the shore, the keel's going to hit the bottom first, and the waves are going to push, so the keel's going to want to go in. These things stiffen that up from ever being a problem. If we weren't planning on running into stuff occasionally and didn't know that happened, then these are completely unnecessary. It's not really a need for this boat to be out in the ocean with it, but it gives us a little more strength, so we're happy with it, and besides, they look awesome. All the braces are welded in today, and all the panels to cover the fuel tanks are done. So we had a good day, and tomorrow it's supposed to be cool. 63 degrees is the high.
This. Does that mean a hardcore? folks.
It's this like is the solution to our bobbin threading issue.
Wow.
Totally. Oh, that's a speed controller and the motor. Somehow the motor engages with that. Oh, cool. Oh, yeah. And then when the bobbin gets full, it automatically yanks. Oh, this is going to be sweet. See, the deal is, there's the tensioner and there's the bobbin. That distance is critical to get the thread to go on there evenly. So, there was much rejoicing in the kingdom. Now what we do to line the steel up is draw a line across and then run the head down and move the steel so that this line is the actual X-axis. Once that's done, everything's good to cut. We put the codes in to make the head pause when it's running. That allows us to set the Z-axis or the gap between the tip and the steel, and that's important to get the cut initiated. Once it's going, the torque-type controller then takes care of any up and down movements that are needed because all steel is a little bit bent. This is actually really good stuff. It's quarter inch. So two steps, like that. Okay, yeah, I don't want. Betsy made muffins for us this morning. We got one left.
Did it. Can you set this for?
Well, I can change the air pressure out back, but it's like 120 now, so we could make it down, we could go down some.
I don't know how tight you are.
Tight.
It's tight,
man. Yeah. No, we're just going to leave them the gaskets and everything will hold the leak. Let's get a wrench on that and see. Oh, yeah. That's tight. Oh, yeah. Nope, that's exactly what we want. All we can do then is we just need to figure out some way of running framing back from those pipes to the corner.
I'll tell you, I got a cat at home and we were talking about our animals and yeah, you know, when we take our cats to the vet, we need to seduce the cat instead of sedate, but you know.
Hey, I like the earplugs.
Huh?
Would you like some real earplugs?
No, these are fine. I was ready for this.
Well, it's all done in cardboard. Now we just got to turn it into steel. The guys did a great job putting this together. Did it work, Aaron?
I'll leave you that one.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Squeeze it. Oh, yeah, okay.
problem.
That looks nice.
Yeah.
Oh, that's nice.
And then which way to go? I just come through a hole. Come through a hole.
All right. Through a hole.
And give yourself enough to hold on to. Okay, flick that forward.
Cool.
Start slow.
Oh, look at that. Oh, that is nice. Does it automatically stop?
No, but it'll kind of stop making noise and then it'll
and then you
off.
Turn it down, turn it off. Oh, it's, look at that. It turned off on its own. Cool. That is a work of art. Betsy figured out our bobbin winder. So, very nicely, tightly wound, very even, beautiful bobbins.
Somewhere. Voila! His ass before he leaves.
Yeah.
You want the shine ass?
What we're doing is we're using silicon bronze wire to weld that in. We found that worked real well last time, and Bart can make it look beautiful with grinder. Is the joint possibly over there is wrong, because it's if we put it up like that, then we flatten the panels out, and if we pull that out it comes over here. But we're thinking we can probably go back later and fix that once this long piece is joined to the one laying underneath it right now. One of the major fallacies with YouTube is there's a lot of videos out there of professionals doing something. And part of the problem with that is you think that when you get home you're going to be able to do it like that. Get that out of your head. Go real slow, do it a couple of times, try different approaches, and you'll get to it. And you'll probably get to something a little bit different than the professionals are doing, and maybe even better.
I think you're going to want to put a fresh bobbin in for each run. That's my guess.
Yeah. Not too much.
there where the seamstress really screwed it up.
Nobody's looking at that.
I am.
I know where there's a small fire in the shop if you can get those up.
No.
Bad character good. Upside down. Shit.
Yeah. This side has a paint on it.
One, two, three.
Oh, yeah. Johan welding away in his tent up there. He's happy as a clam. Finally a deck to walk on. The bow. Sweet. Been a long time coming, hasn't it? Look at those welds, they're great. Beautiful job. Yeah, no grinding on that. So our sail is going to be an inch and a half narrower than planned because somebody forgot to add an inch and a half for the tabling on the outside of the forward edge. Yeah, I can't imagine who'd do that. That was pretty. Johan gets a little close to his weld and he actually melted his shield. That's hot. My welder won't work as hard. That's the difference between what he's running, which is an Invertec 300, which I have to do, I don't know, about 350 amps. This is an Ironman 210, and it's making me wait because it gets too hot. I've only done one plate. It started a little bit ahead of me, but not that much. So I have to sit and wait for it to cool down. And I am running it on its highest setting, but I like penetration. People tell you, why are welding doesn't penetrate? Well, turn the goddamn thing up. You blow holes through the side of the boat if you're not careful. Isn't that right, Johan? You know you've burned a hole through the boat. I have you on tape doing it. Burn a hole right,
you're gonna make me fake
right through the side of the boat.
You gotta use stick welder to get any penetration. Wire welding just doesn't penetrate. Come on.